Here at Cosworth, and that's the group end drive. Right, spin round or split to the finish. Easy going round. Yeah, back I'm going off the line, that's new. I'm getting the ring now. More affordable, almost like a junior championship in the World Rally Championship. But the R5s are an absolutely difficult car, only maybe a car that's a world class driver. Show the program, and it tells you that down near the Berger ramp, if you look down that way, you'll see your siren car guys lining up to take people for rally car rides. If you go down to that hill, you can book a ride with Sierra Cosworth green door. We just had Steve Gunko off the line there in another WRC. That was WRC 05. He had several overall wins on the Irish Tarmac Championship before Melvin Evans Motorsports took it to the International Championship in various clubs as well. The white Subaru is going down to the Rossler Park, the Pro Drive car. The driver of that is actually Paul Howard, who is the Director of Operations for Aston Martin Racing, part of the fairly famous Subaru Impreza. This one is the one that Colin McRae used. I think it was 1997 for McRae. Look at the history of it. That one actually got second place in Argentina and it won the Safari. Obviously, it was slightly different body scale from the Safari car, but that is the car that Colin McRae drove. Now the Escort Cosworth has come off the line. That's a very special car. That is the first ever Ford Escort Cosworth. That was a development car. The actual original development car. Sat on the line at the moment, we've got Will Nichols in another road driving Brexit. We're coming round now to the polo shaped, I don't quite remember what the phrase was, but these proto cars, yeah. Basically, underneath the skin of that polo look like a bit of the evolution, bits and pieces, and a more modern body shell. Unfortunately, the MSA won't allow these cars to compete on British Championship events, but they're quite happy to come along and demonstrate the ability of the car in front of you. Another very, very interesting car. car that just got off the line in the open fleet before back to us. It was actually ever rally. And it's the first ever car to use an active central differential. And Jimmy McRae drove that car to Miss Overall on the 1994 rally. On the Monte Carlo rally by Danny Snowbeck, and Brian made it in private hands. So, Steve Bagson, the Mercedes who sort of started to find their way about it a little bit. See, the Cleaver carries on around this way while the McRae Subaru wheels off. Bastos livery car. That was actually my 3X, my Taylor Engineering development car. But they developed their version of the Cogwood. Charlie Smith, the winner, he feels off the right to the paddock. Only the second ever closed road rally to be held in England. That's up in the northwest of England, based around north of Preston. Using some of the old classic road rally stages, but closed to full blown rally cars, which is quite interesting. We've got the Proton turn coming round at the moment. Another Escort World Rally car is one of Darrell Taylor there. Chased down by John Blake. John Blake is after a very, very, very big accident on the Banks International thinking flat here. But he told me he wasn't to be in the show. Just out any problems. Of course, got the little maxi kit cars now made it back to the line, so let's see how that goes. The around with this 306 Max.
You can tell when it's
either this afternoon or tomorrow, depending on what time we get here, is that Chris Ingram, the European Jubilee Rally champion, will be driving that car. That's quite interesting to see a guy who's right at the top of the game at the moment. He's doing the European Championship at the moment for Skoda in an R5. So let's see how he gets on with a Formula 2 kit car. So we've got Stuart Newby, Gretzky coming back to the line. Sal and Gary did the Vortex board, didn't really know how to do a rally car together. I used to navigate in one of Stuart's impressors that he used to dominate local road rallies. My driver bought the car and I navigated for him for the season. But we never quite got the same kind of results as Stuart managed to get. Martin will be going out in the Repsol liveried Escort Cosworth. And this is an Escort built car. It's actually the wrecking car for Carlos Sainz and Louis Moya. It's a Group N version of World Cup. They would have competed on the World Championship in Group A cars. An avionics engineer with the Royal Air Force, and the car's been built by RAC. I just wondered whether the launch control is capable. So we have done quite a few events in various other cars, little Novas he was always well known for. It. Got Mark Barnes gone off the line there in the Fiat 500. That's the car that runs in the R3 class. British Rally, it's a 1400 turbo, and I've already developed a kit for it, so I could buy a kit of parts to put on the sequential gearboxes, and Carmack Rally Championship. He's had class wins on the Banks Rally with it a few times, and tells me he's put down to about 190 grand. That's a car that he bought at the WRAC Rally a few times. It's a Cadet GSI petrol car, I think, two-litre engine. John has also brought with him his Porsche GT3 RS, but he hasn't actually taken it out on the stage yet. But let's all hope with a little bit more persuasion we're really going out and see how he goes for us. It's only inside the deck, which is 300 odd horsepower Porsche. Said now we're 190 horsepower of Fiat 500 turbo. Gone at 400 written by Paul Kaiser. So I don't think he's going to stay ahead of that Subaru for too long. The line again at the moment is Steve Rutherford. As I said before, this is the one that was driven by Valentino Rossi on the rally.
Going around there is one man who certainly knows how to drive a Skoda.
Chris Birkbeck, who owns and runs a rally preparation company. Also, runs a rally school. Teacher has to be able to do it as well as anybody else, so he certainly knows how to drive. But Chris Birkbeck is another of these drivers that started off in the Peugeot Championship and was quite synonymous with the Peugeots, but also well known in the 80s for container ships, back Dovers and Astra GTEs. So he's quite often on the British Championship events, but rather rapidly in the Group A category. That car went off the line because the Lotus Esprit of Terry Maynard is one interesting car. It's been used on various events before it nowadays does this type of demonstration stuff. Back when it was a rally cross, very difficult car to drive, extremely twitchy, just didn't handle at all. And he eventually ended up with Championship and so he's very experienced at driving these cars. Unfortunately, Chris cannot go out around here without a certain amount of embarrassment, because he was the first person ever to roll on one of our events. If you recall last year on the previous stage at the other end of the barn, he turned into our corner just a little bit early, just clipped a little bit of a bump, and over it went. Luckily the team from Falcon Motorsport managed to sort it out. Another interesting Peugeot that's going around at the moment is the 309 GTI of Graham Surrey. This is a Group N car, and that was originally part of the Peugeot Young Lions Challenge. And that was a car that was actually borrowed by Colin McRae to do an event, do some Scottish Championship stuff, when Colin was just a wee lad and just getting into this rally car. And in that car, he class wins on the Granite City, he won the Skip Round Rally, class wins on the KL Graphics and on the Queen Rally, all round the British Championship. And then he went to the banks and threw it into the scenery in true Colin McRae style. But the car's been restored, and as you see here today, as part of the anniversary of the Peugeot Championship. Mark Young there in that white 205, that's actually got a 2-litre GTI 6 engine in the world. And Mark Young back to the club event for some of the years in the Peugeots, gained quite a few class wins. An interesting car on the line at the moment is the Ferrari 308 GTV. This is the car's shakedown event. It's only just been finished, and probably something like a 5-year program to have this car. But
thank you. Yeah. Yeah, I'll fish, you get it.
Yeah, I don't know.